Hey everybody. If you guys are new here, I'm working on an immersive sim FPS, similar to the likes of Deus Ex and Half-Life, but with faster paced combat and retro graphics. But anyways, I started off the week by implementing some of your guys' suggestions, namely CM5s, who recommended that spotlights should be manned by enemies instead of just being automated, which I think is pretty cool. So in order to get the AI to use the spotlight, I needed a system for them to interact with it. And while I already have a system for AI to interact with doors and things like that, there wasn't really any way for me to get the AI to interact with a spotlight. So I first made a vehicle system, which is just an interactable that, when interacted with, forces the interactor to be set to a certain position. And in order for the AI to want to go use vehicles, I had to make an AI goal that searches for nearby vehicles and makes the AI go to the closest available one. After making the AI go into the spotlight, I then needed to toggle the spotlight based on if something was using it. This also means that the switch on the spotlight was basically useless, so I ended up removing it. I then had to solve a bunch of bugs relating to AI leaving vehicles. But after all that was sorted, the AI now know how to look for vehicles, then enter the vehicles, and then exit them if they need to fight an enemy or something like that. I think the system works well enough for right now, but in the future I want to polish it up and add IK and animations so enemies actually hold the spotlight. As right now, it looks a little bit weird as they just kind of stand there. Also, as CM5 recommended, I also made the spotlight a bit more visible, so you know if you're in the spotlight's view or not. But moving on from spotlight, I then wanted to remake the player, as the arm models and body models have been around since the start of the project, and by now they look pretty crappy. So I first started off by taking the arm model and just adding a bunch more polygons, you know, making edges smoother and things like that, which I think looks more in line with the newer models that I have in the game. I then decided to texture hands, which wasn't really necessary, so they look a little bit goofy, but it doesn't really matter because I'm covering them up with gloves. Which, speaking of gloves, I then modeled and textured gloves. Then finally, the jacket on the arms. To be honest, I don't think there is that much of a quality difference between the old and new arms, but I think it was necessary to remake them, as I wanted them to be remade in Substance Painter instead of Blender. I've only recently been using Substance Painter, but it's been so much faster and easier to texture things. This is because in Blender, without fancy shader tricks, you really only have one layer to paint on. But in Substance, you could have as many layers as you like. So, if for example I wanted to change the color of the leather on the gloves, in Substance, I can just, you know, slide a slider. But in Blender, I would have to open up the texture and then edit it in Photoshop or something, which is a huge hassle and is really slow and inefficient. So yeah, not only do the arms look better, they're also way easier for me to improve in the future. I then followed the same process and remade the player body. But unlike the arms, I really think the player body needed to be remade, as it looks a little bit familiar. Now the player has some cool new boots, a belt, and a leather jacket. And after making the player body, I made a bunch of new animations, which should make the movement feel a lot smoother. When falling, the player now sways their feet. And when sliding, the player now slides in the direction of their velocity. Moving on from the player, I then remade these wooden crates, which were also made at the start of the project and looked bad even back then. And sticking with the theme of visual changes, I also made a bunch of changes to the blood effects. I made a new shader for blood decals, which makes the blood look like it's now pooling in. I did this by increasing a timer that, using UV coordinates, reveals the alpha, which is then multiplied by a noise texture, giving a gradient that looks close enough to liquid pouring out. You might have noticed there is also a bunch of newer, higher quality blood textures and decals, which make the game overall feel a lot grittier and less cartoony, which is definitely something I'm going for. I also made a bunch of changes to bullet hole effects. In the first versions of my game, I had 3D bullet holes, similar to the ones in Fear. But when I updated to newer versions of Unity, the shaders that I was using for these bullet holes broke. But alas, around a year since those bullet holes were deleted, I finally have 3D bullet holes again. And now, the new bullet holes use a parallax shader, which should be a lot more optimized than the old bullet holes, which used a bunch of meshes. The last thing that I worked on is a new crosshair. The crosshair now adapts to where the bullets are actually going to land, because in Partizan, the bullets actually come from the weapon's barrel, unlike in most games, where they come from the player's camera. The crosshair now also adapts to weapon spread and recoil, which looks great when you're spraying away, but does also generally help the player know where they're shooting. And while I generally think the crosshair looks okay, I made sure to add the option to disable the sort of weapon following in case players are finding it too distracting, which I think can happen. I also removed the old interactable UI, replacing it with the crosshair, as it sort of encapsulates things that you can interact with. But I did find this pretty distracting when fighting enemies, as it would adapt to nearby crops and things like that. So I ended up just kind of disabling it when you have a weapon equipped, but now you can't really tell what you can or can't interact with unless you have your weapon holstered. Let me know what you guys think of this approach in the comments below. Like, should I bring back the old interactable UI, or maybe have the crosshair adapt no matter what? Let me know, as I'm not really 100% happy with how it works right now. Anyways, that's pretty much it. Next video, I'm probably gonna work on the enemy models, as in contrast to the player models, they look pretty bad. Also, I know this video's format was a bit different to my other videos, so let me know what you guys prefer. Do you prefer the more showcasey videos like my other videos, or more like these, where I actually go into depth on how I did things? Anyways, if you enjoyed this video, you should subscribe. You could do so by clicking there. And if you want to watch more videos like this, then you could go watch another video over there. That's kind of it. See ya.